Hi everyone, and welcome back. We are playing actually Genshin tonight. Honestly, I have not played Genshin in a while. So, we still have a lot of story to catch up on before we even get to Fontaine, to be fair. So I'm gonna work on the dailies. There's no way I'm getting the battle pass this time. Honestly, I have not been working on it often enough. I need to actually at least do dailies. But until then, we are going to get done at least a little bit of what we can and continue on. So that you guys know. Oh yeah. Oh, that's in Fontaine. So the one thing I did do completely off stream is I got him. I think I was actually at 70 already, so I had to do single pulls. I got him at like 80 or like 83. So we do have him. We got our free copy of Lynette. And who is on this banner? We still have to. I'm gonna start off with the standard. Because we have 10. We might as well. Start off with the 10 pull. Standard, but still. Okay, we got another Candace. That's nice. Honestly, I can't be mad about that. It is a new month, so we do get more wishes. And we don't have enough of that. What? I'm gonna make the 30 wishes on this one. Just because. If I get a second child, I would rather have child constellations than Zhongli. I really need to get to the story because I know there's some stuff that goes down with him, and I really need to catch up on story. I'm pretty sure there's not going to be gold. Oh, Noelle. Pretty sure we already have C6 Noelle. More temple. Are we only going to get the 1 4-star? No characters. But I want the little boy. I want all three siblings. Sayu. Sayu even on the banner? Okay, she is. So that's 5. Even though I have that one, it's just not on him. So, yeah, this is why I'm saying we're not getting the battle pass this time. There's 20 days, and there's no way I can get it. Even with getting all the event stuff, there's just no way. So I save a little bit of money this month. Okay. Let's go do the dailies. Actually, we also need to. Give me 1 second. I just wanted to check the setting. Huh. For some reason, my connection's unstable. And I don't know if it's just because the game's gotten bigger or things are being weird tonight. There we go. So I just wanted to check. Oh, so C6. C3 Candace. That's actually not bad. I do like the new like loading pages. Oh, they're so pretty. That's the buttons. I'm used to playing Minecraft where the buttons are. Maybe I will focus on the story. Yeah. Just because I think if I do a bit more of the story. Then I don't have, and I'm not worrying about the battle pass, so I don't have to worry about using resin. So much for just sneaking in and stealing that stuff. Sadly, that reminds me of freaking D&D. Basically, that's the first one. Yeah, I passed my skill check. Second one, miserably failed. So, yeah.
Keep up.
I need to make sure my hands are on the right keys. And this is like on the same island, so I'm just gonna go. Granted, I don't usually have my party in this order. You are usually there. I know it's in running distance, I'm still teleporting. actually gave me decent items. I'll teleport up after I collect the dailies.
Add Astra. Thank you for coming. Add Astra.
Good enough party.
Scribe? Please, wait. Are you Scribe Alhatham?
That's me. Is something the matter? I'm in a hurry.
No. I was just surprised to see you here. I had heard that the sages were looking for you not long ago, but I didn't know what for. And, also, please don't bring outside guests into the academia.
Outside guests? How did you arrive at such a conclusion? Your groundless inference shames the Haravatar Darshan.
What did you say? I'm the top student in Haravatar, and I earned third place at the last Inter-Darshan debate. Don't look down on me!
That wasn't my intention. As your Haravatar senior, I just assumed that you possessed a greater aptitude for critical thinking. Look, based on what you already know, the purpose of my return and the reason they're here should be obvious.
Is that so? Wait a moment. Let me think. Don't tell me the answer. The sages search for you. A blonde-haired traveler. Outside guests. So, from the start, the sages weren't looking for you, but this traveler? And you were gone from the academia for so long because...
Hey, shh. Yes, you've proven yourself as the top student in Haravatar. I surmise you've arrived at the correct conclusion.
As I expected. Please, forgive me. I wasn't thinking clearly just now. Thank you for getting me back on track.
It's nothing. We'll be on our way then.
All right. Thank you for your contributions to the academia, Scribe.
What the heck just happened now? What did he just guess?
I'm afraid I don't know either.
You have no idea?
Mm-hmm. He convinced himself of whatever truth he came up with. That is the so-called pride of a scholar. If someone questions their academic facility, they will instantly feign understanding to keep up appearances. Nowadays, the academia is rampant with this type of scholar. Their obvious farces of intellect only serve to highlight themselves as fools.
Wow. So there are special ways to deal with smart people. We don't even need to make up our own excuses.
We shouldn't waste any more time. It would be problematic if we missed our window of opportunity. Let's go. Indeed. Known as the House of Dana, it is quite possibly the most extensive special collections library in Teyvat.
There are a lot of students going through here. Is it really okay just to waltz right in?
The Academia marches to a fast beat, especially since it's Nagarbaha Day. They're all occupied with their own matters. Just act natural. Now, hurry along. It's a lift that Academia personnel use to access higher floors.
Are we gonna take it then? The Grand Sage's office is up there somewhere.
No, not right now. We can't guarantee that we won't run into the Grand Sage. Let's step back and observe for now.
You think the Grand Sage will exit from there? After he does, we'd sneak past him? Oh, Paimon thinks that's really dangerous.
Who knows? However, if we can confirm Azar's current location, our operation will be much safer if we...
Allow me to offer you a hint. If you wish to know his location, look behind you.
Oh, hey buddy, how are you? Long time no see.
Suspicious of you after such a prolonged absence, Scribe. An eyewitness had informed me of your whereabouts, so I came to personally welcome you.
Grand Sage, I didn't expect you to care so much about me. I'm truly flattered.
I'm sure, but compared to you, I am far more interested in these two unexpected guests. You are the Traveler and Paimon, correct? It's a pity that only now have I been afforded the opportunity to formally meet two of Sumeru's most esteemed guests. I do apologize for my lack of decorum. Excellent. You immediately initiated discussion instead of attempting to prepare some perfunctory excuse. You clearly understand the situation at hand, and have no intention of making a reckless stand. The foot traffic here renders this place unsuitable for discussion. Please, follow me to my office.
Oh, if you wouldn't be too kind, so kind, just lead us there. I don't know why I just kind of took a southern tone.
This place is crawling with guards. There's no way out for us.
All right then, Traveler. What did you wish to discuss with me? Today is Nagarbaha Day, so I still have many responsibilities to attend to. There is little time for idle chit-chat before I detain you. Seem to know quite a bit about our endeavors. If that is so, then you should be praising our great work rather than using your trivial misgivings in a futile attempt to sway me.
Trivial?
Then tell me, what do the Fatui want from me? Worthless. Those are all completely worthless benefits. Divine power. These materialistic words do nothing but debase our great work. Creating a god. Yes, we are using human wisdom to create a god. If humanity cannot attain omniscience and omnipotence, then we shall create a god to reveal them. This is the pinnacle of human wisdom.
Are human crazy?
We shall regain a god's guidance at long last. No longer will we flounder in the interminable void of consciousness and knowledge. Even Ermin's soul will be freed from its plight. For our nation of scholars, this is the ultimate aspiration. No cost is too great to realize it. You will never understand the rapture of having a god be born within your very hands. With your degree of knowledge, you cannot even comprehend such an emotion.
You're crazy.
Gods exist on a plane that far eclipses humanity's. Lesser Lord Kusanali, what can she even do? Care for the people? Fend off sandstorms? Fabricate silly fairy tales? These are but child's play for the academia. Does that make us equal to the gods? We are a people favored by Greater Lord Rukadevata. Though I may have personally not seen it, our forefathers bore witness to true wisdom. The ascension of the Lesser Lord has brought nothing but bewilderment to the scholars. They all ask, is that truly what true wisdom is supposed to look like? With that in mind, it is better to keep her isolated in the sanctuary of Surasthana, so our academy will not become embroiled in turmoil.
Super smart or powerful should be able to call themselves gods?
As per your judgment, Grand Sage, they are indeed dangerous individuals. Not only are they acting against the academia, but their ideologies have the potential to lead scholars astray. Looks like there really was merit in my assignment.
Ahathem? Are you talking about us?
Anyway, I've brought them to the academia as ordered, but it took some time and trouble. Oh, that reminds me. Here's the investigation report you had requested. It's a summary of my time spent with the Traveler, an array of information about her, ready for your perusal.
Excellent. Detailed contents with no errors. I would expect nothing less than an immaculate report from the scribe. As it is Niagara Day, I'll enter the information on you into the Akasha. Surely you know what that means.
We'll be monitored, just like Sino.
With the Akasha's calculation prowess, all of your actions will be predicted with an accuracy of at least 98%. Furthermore, your data will be updated in real time whenever new information presents itself. To put it into words you can understand, wherever you go, you will be walking under an invisible leash. This is Sumeru's greatest penalty for dishonest persons. Are you not familiar with the concept that great responsibility begets an equally great suspicion? In any case, you are Sumeru's most concerning external variable. Locking you down will greatly decrease the chance of any undesirable outcomes coming to pass.
You're despicable!
Despicable? Perhaps from your perspective, but your ploy was to sacrifice the Traveler here, wasn't it?
Lord Azar, I know what you're trying to say, but I've been following your plan this entire time.
Must I delineate your entire plan? Very well. I will spell things out. First off, I received an eyewitness report that you were spotted with the Traveler to Caravan Rebot. However, you immediately departed for the desert and escaped surveillance range. Judging by the time, you all likely encountered the truant General Mahamatra in the desert. Am I correct?
Maybe Barman shouldn't have mentioned Sino just now.
The academia had not received correspondence from its scribe for a prolonged time. You were also in the company of the Traveler, a close associate of Lesser Lord Kusanali and General Mahamatra Sino, who had defected from the academia. With their instigation, what was the probability that you would betray the academia? Rationally speaking, 50%? 70%? What do you think?
Regardless, that's only a guess. The facts are that I've brought the Traveler right before you, and I gave you my report.
Indeed, your boldness deserves praise. To think that despite status as an outlander, the Traveler is still willing to sacrifice for the sake of your plan. If I'm correct, you have a contingency plan to save Lesser Lord Kusanali and ruin our great work. Sneak into the academia on Nia Garbaha Day, using Alhatham's status as the scribe. For there is a good chance that an opportunity to save the Lesser Lord will arise. Should your intentions be discovered, Alhatham will turn traitor and sacrifice the Traveler, thus proving his innocence. He can then stay inside the academia and continue searching for a way to proceed forward. As for Sino, according to the Akasha's calculations, he will soon return to...
You'll see me as a traitor regardless of what I say. No, even if you impugn me, it would have little effect on you all.
You misunderstand. Losing our scribe would irreparably damage the Academia's regular operations and the development of Sumeru's future academic systems. However, under the current circumstances, even that is trivial compared to what we stand to gain from our great work.
You said that I betrayed the Academia, but you, Azar, you've betrayed all of Sumeru, betrayed its Archon.
So flight has turned to fight at long last. Guards! Desperation. Aren't you doing the exact same thing as me, Alhatham? Unfortunately for you, no god will lend you their power. Azar! He has gone completely insane. Take him to the Matra, and exile him to Aru village. Then, find someone to take these two to the confinement room. I'll deal with them later.
Grand Sage, we've finished all required preparations for Nia Garbaha Day. We may begin to enter the capsules now.
Excellent. You may begin.
I have a good cat. Storm's just sitting behind me.
Made it into confinement, and all Alhatham's knows how to cook up a plan. What are we doing next? Paimon has trouble remembering things when she's worked up. Right, right. Paimon thinks it went something like this.
Apart from that, we still have yet another goal in the first stage of our operation, which is to send the Traveler to the confinement room. She's always been the person the sages are most afraid of, as well as the greatest obstacle to the successful implementation of their plan. They are very aware of the risk she poses to them. Once the Traveler is imprisoned, the sages will likely think that everything is under control. And with their guard down, the next phase of our plan will have a much higher chance of success.
I can already see the pompous looks on their faces.
Tricky plan, but Paimon still thinks it's not really worth it.
That isn't the only reason, of course. She has a more important task once she's in confinement. According to the academia scholars in Ramon's custody, Lesser Lord Kusanali has sealed off her consciousness in the Akasha ever since she was captured by the Doctor. That way, they can't pry any more information from her. Even if we break into the sanctuary of Surasthana, it will take time to awaken Lesser Lord Kusanali's consciousness. We need to do that in advance.
So our job is to wake up Nahida! Okay, totally worth getting thrown in jail for!
The confinement room is inside the academia, close to the sanctuary of Surasthana. It's a completely enclosed space, and you won't be receiving any visitors. I'll work with Ramon scholars to make some modifications to your Akasha terminal. Once you're in, get as close as you can to Lesser Lord Kusanali and try to connect to her consciousness. However, as for whether she'll actually wake up, that will depend on our luck.
I know it's a place.
Here? No signal again. Is it getting jammed?
I love this part for Nahida. Like, this is the last part I did before. But I still will.
Nahida!
know where the Archon. So I've kept studying. Kept listening to my people and their hearts. Kept looking for a way to save Ermin's soul. So I can catch up. Catch up to Greater Lord Rukatavata. But I'm stuck in the sanctuary of Sarasthana. The sages are creating a god to replace me. And I'm forced to lock my consciousness in this boundless darkness.
Nahida!
Now that I think of it, I don't think I've ever actually listened to my own inner voice. Do Archons have them? Should Archons have them?
Yes.
Have I been doing the right thing? Am I really not needed? How do I really feel about all of this?
Since you're the god of wisdom, you've known the answers to all these questions since the very beginning, haven't you?
Who are you? Whose voice is that? It sounds familiar. You're right, though. I don't think my own voice anymore. Everything that's happened to me, I feel really angry now.
You should have been angry ages ago.
Mm-hmm. To be fair, I like the performance as well.
Nilu, are you sure about this? You're taking such a great risk for them.
I'm sure, and I'm going. You know that I don't like to pass up any opportunity to dance, and this one is especially important.
All right. You seem to have a lot of trust in them, so I won't say more on the subject. But if anything happens, the few of us here may not be able to help you.
Don't worry. They've been through worse. Everything's going to be fine.
All right. You know, if you really do get arrested, we'll do everything we can to get you back. Be careful, even if it's only for our sakes.
So you guys, I need to check the stream again. It was a little okay. It looked a little choppy for me when I was watching it. Because there is a delay, so I get to see some of it. But yeah.
Thanks, Mr.
Connection's still good.
You're so very kind.
Nilu, how's it going? Nervous?
Definitely more than usual. But it's because I'm worried I won't dance well enough.
It's okay. Just focus on your performance. We'll take care of everything else.
You sure know how to talk. Taking all the credit, even though we came here together to help out.
Well, thank you both. I'll have to treat you to a meal after all this ends. I really, really appreciate all of your help.
Ooh, that sounds great. Huh. How can we say no to that?
All right, let's get back to business. Nilu, we'll be here to keep people from going to the academia so they don't interrupt your performance.
I was planning on telling them something like, the academia has been conducting a weird experiment, and...
Oh, you couldn't think of anything better? Oh well, I guess it does sound like something the academia would do.
Mm-hmm.
I think it sounds great. I'm counting on you guys.
Don't worry. It'll be a piece of cake.
Hey, I don't know why you have to run.
Sorry, it's great to see you, but I'm really busy right now. Our bait people away with Yaldacandy's plan is working beautifully. Do you want some candy? We have more than we can give out.
Vihar, thank you so much for doing all of this. And even dressed up as the Knight of Flowers, no less. I'll pass on the candy, though. I cut back on sweets in the period leading up to a performance, and I'm about to start one.
You have a point. The stage is cleared and everything's ready, so you can start your performance at any time.
Yeah, thanks to you. I'm really grateful. All right, time to hit the stage.
You're welcome. The honor's all mine, since I'll have such a great view of the show.
Oh, I'm tired. Wow. I feel like I'm just, like, exhausted, like, in the last 5 minutes. But I ain't going to do this.
Seen a performance like this. This is incredible.
Yeah, but I heard that public performances like these have been banned. I can't believe she's doing this here.
Grand Sage, there's some commotion outside.
How uninteresting. Issue the new Prohibition Act from the Akasha to the guards. They'll know what to do.
I think we should, like, stop her.
Let's just watch for a little bit longer.
plan has moved on to the next stage? Yep, yep. It's great that everything seems to be going well. Come to think of it, when did Alhatham replace the knowledge capsule that was about to be entered into the Akasha? Oh, so that's when he did it! Paimon was too nervous to notice. Speaking of, didn't Alhatham also yoink the divine knowledge capsule from that mercenary leader in Port Ormos?
Which is why I like him.
Oh, it's a time-tested trick of his. Why are we complimenting him? Yeah, he's smart and all, but he still makes Paimon's blood boil. Let's review our plan for this stage again. It's not like we have anything else to do right now anyway, and it'll help us feel more confident.
Honestly, I wish they wouldn't.
Lesser Lord Kusanali's consciousness has been forcefully sealed. The core figures of the Academia and their guards have started to wear their Akasha terminals again. With the Doctor's technological support, they think they have nothing to fear.
How despicable of them to rely on such a person.
But this is also our chance. I was originally asked to draft the knowledge capsule for the Artistic Performances Prohibition Act when I was still at the Academia. It should be on the Grand Sage's desk right now, and will be entered into the Akasha during the next Nyagarbaha day.
Are they really going to stop all artistic performances? That's horrible!
I'll make an identical knowledge capsule, but this time, I'll smuggle some misleading information into it. We only need to find an opportunity to switch the capsules. Once it's been entered into the Akasha on Nyagarbaha day, if someone were to be seen performing in public, the sages would definitely use that opportunity to announce the ban. And so, the misleading information will be disseminated amongst the guards.
Sure sounds complicated, but it seems like if everything goes well, we'll be able to get rid of all the guards in the Academia without any effort. That's pretty clever, getting right into their heads. I just have one question. Even if we manage to get the misleading info out to the guards, how can we be sure that they'll believe it?
People who are used to relying on the Akasha become less inquisitive, and their ability to distinguish truth from misinformation is significantly reduced. They will view everything the Akasha releases to them as the unequivocal truth.
The Akasha will turn humans into machines. I've seen it happen many times.
Yikes. Good thing I didn't wear it for long when I was working in Sumeru City. At first, I thought it was a good thing, too. By the way, this plan still requires a performer, right?
Do you have someone in mind?
Nilu of Zubair Theater. I know her really well. We can trust her. I'm kinda hesitant to ask her to participate in a dangerous plan like this, but we can ask her in person.
All right. After the guards in the Academia are gone,
then it'll be time for me and my stowaway brothers to shine. Here they come. Did you see that, Raman? They came out from the Academia in droves.
Laying low in the city for so long, this is the moment we've been waiting for. My brothers have already sprung into action.
We couldn't do anything to them inside their coop, but outside the Academia, this is our hunting ground.
With a lioness like you, the prey sure won't be able to run far.
We still need to eliminate the guards as soon as possible. If we give the sages enough time to realize what's happening, the plan's doomed.
Yeah. All they've done is to sit on their cushy salaries and twiddle their thumbs all day while we fought and struggled every day in the desert. The only advantage they might have is their numbers.
Speaking of which, most of the guards who report directly to the Six Sages belong to the Corps of 30, but they have a completely different reputation. Following those blasted sages every whim, throwing away all the principles of being a mercenary, as someone in the same profession, I'm obligated to teach them a good lesson today.
Indeed, the trap has been set. All we need to do is lead them there.
All right, let's each take a road and herd those scattered guards back into one place. Make sure sure to attract their attention. Aesop would be the key.
You gave such an important task to that child. Will he be okay?
It'll be fine. Aesop was so determined to help, so let's put our faith in him. Besides, even if he's caught, the guards would be too scared to do anything to him. They've never seen Lesser Lord Kusanali in person, after all.
You've got a point. Anyway, I think I see them coming. Let's head out.
Good luck.
Here, you'll pretend to be Lesser Lord Kusanali and run away from them.
Oh, yeah, I remember. Of course I do. I'm just a little nervous.
Relax. Don't think about getting caught. Even if that happens, we won't leave you behind.
Let's see if I can do this
you
the first time.
You only need to think about getting the guards' attention and leading them to the Grand Bazaar. Leave the rest to us.
Okay, got it. I'm here to pay back Lesser Lord Kusanali helping Grandpa. I won't get cold feet.
Hey, they're here. I can see the academia cart.
All right, it's time, Aesop. Take it.
Why is there a guard over there? Did he already run ahead of me? There's no time. I need to make...
Huh? Did I just see something dart by? I'd better go have a look. Were my eyes playing tricks on me? I should go check to see if someone's hiding over there. There seems to be nothing here. Just to be safe.
This is going to be different, but I'm kind of glad.
Hey! Lesser Lord Kusanali is over there! Stop!
What? Lesser Lord Kusanali? How did I not see anything just now?
Oh no, they found me. Where should I go?
The target suspected to be Lesser Lord Kusanali has escaped into the Grand Bazaar. Assemble and arrest her! How did she disappear? Did we lose her? Hurry up and find her!
Hey, why is your team here? Didn't we say to split up our search?
Hurry, hurry! This place is... Why are you all here?
Yeah, isn't it one heck of a coincidence? Everybody's here. What on earth is going on? I suppose that's all of you?
Who are you? Did you set us up? What are you planning?
Phew. That was rough. I almost got caught.
Little brat! So you're not actually Lesser Lord Kusanali. Who exactly are you all? Eremites from the desert?
Just some colleagues. Think of this as a business competition. Or a personal grudge. After stepping into our traps, stop thinking of yourselves as hunters. Behave like the prey you are.
An ambush? How's that possible? This is Sumeru City, but mercenaries from the desert somehow ambushed us!
You've spent all your time hiding away in the academia. This place has long since become our hunting ground. Brace yourselves!
Like, I like getting glimpses into others, but, like...
This is odd. The academia has quieted down after the conclusion of the Niagara Day these ceremonies.
Sorry, guys. It feels like I have something stuck in my teeth.
Where are the guards? Why have I not seen a single one?
Guards? Guards!
Grand Sage, how may I be of assistance?
I called for the guards. Why did you come?
My apologies, Grand Sage. Right now, all Academia guards have entered the city to perform the ordered arrest. I thought you knew.
Arrest? Who is there to arrest? I have an ominous feeling.
Arrest Lesser Lord Kusanali, right? Is that not what the order was?
Lesser Lord Kusanali? You mean she has disappeared?
Yes. I wouldn't dare make up something like that. Right now, everyone is in a panic, and many are saying that Lesser Lord Kusanali will take revenge on us.
What happened? Just what is going on? Lesser Lord Kusanali somehow escaped. Was it Alhatham and his party that freed her? That's impossible. The Academia is heavily guarded today, and any order to release Lesser Lord Kusanali would be strictly confidential. Besides, Alhatham and the Traveler are already in our hands. What manner of trickery did they employ? How could Lesser Lord Kusanali disappear into thin air? Disappear? Wait. How was the arrest order distributed to the guards?
It was issued by the Akasha earlier today. Only you have the authority to send messages like that, so I thought it was your order.
Let me check. Here. Lesser Lord Kusanali has escaped from the sanctuary of Surstana. Go to the city and arrest the escapee immediately. The Akasha indeed contains this information, and it clearly appeared in my mind. How did they bypass my permission? Was it the report about the Traveler that Alhatham submitted? No. I specifically checked that knowledge capsule before entering it into the Akasha. Red herring. Well, even if I figure it out now, it won't make any difference. The important thing now is to confirm Lesser Lord Kusanali's status. Have you been to the sanctuary of Surasthana to confirm that Lesser Lord Kusanali has indeed escaped?
Confirm? No, I haven't. It may be a bit offensive to say this, but Grand Sage, what you're saying doesn't make any sense. How can
Hey, Mitch, thank you for lurking.
Inaccurate. What the Akasha decrees is fact. That is common knowledge to all of us. If we have to confirm the information and knowledge from the Akasha ourselves, then how is that any different from us learning that information ourselves? Wouldn't Greater Lord Rukadavata's legacy lose its meaning that way?
In the beginning, it was I who asked you to believe in the Akasha, to believe in the legacy left by Greater Lord Rukadavata. Are you trying to use my words against me?
No, Grand Sage. I'm merely confused because I believe in you. I never meant to refute you.
Stay here and see if there are any suspicious people around. I'll go to the sanctuary of Surasthana on my own.
Yes, Grand Sage.
Okay. I don't know actually what happens from this point on. Like, I know what that happens, but still.
Sanctuary of Surasthana. Go to the city and arrest the escapee immediately. How can that be? Just stop thinking about it. Stop. It must be a trick of theirs. As long as I personally confirm it. Ah! Impossible. That's impossible. There must be something wrong with my eyes. She really appeared again? What is the meaning of this?
What a comical sight is Azar. Once the Akasha has put certain thoughts into your head, even the Grand Sage can no longer see what's right in front of him. You all can only see the world in your mind, the one you think you know. And precisely because of this, you disregarded Lesser Lord Kusanali's existence. She has been a wise and worthy Archon.
Sino, have you been waiting for a chance like this? The Akasha predicted that you would return to the Academia to confront me, but I didn't expect it to turn out like this. I was careless.
No, you were blinded. Your faults stem from your reliance on the Akasha. You're still the same as always.
I truly did not expect a proud person like you to cooperate with Al-Haytham and the Traveler.
People change, Azar. Admit it. The Akasha can't predict my actions anymore.
Then tell me, what have you found during your investigation?
You want to buy time? This is the sanctuary of Suristhana. Under your own regulations, even Academia staff are forbidden to come here. No one will come to save you. As for the investigation, I've at least confirmed that you are guilty of insurgency against the Archon. A serious crime.
So what? Did you do all of this so I would plead guilty in front of you, General Mahamatra?
No. I want you to plead guilty in front of the Archon herself. You once said that I had no standing to judge you. So now, how about judgment in the name of a god?
Mm-hmm.
Here comes your savior.
Yeah! Paimon just knew you would come to rescue us!
You two really owe me some big thanks. I had to search through who knows how many guards to find the key here. It felt even more tiring than whacking them. I'm exhausted.
Thanks a lot. Need Paimon to rub your shoulders?
No, that's, I'll pass.
What are you afraid of? Oh, are you ticklish?
Now isn't the time to talk about being ticklish. Things in the city and on Sino's side are both going well. The guards that stormed out at the Academia are all taken care of. The Corps of 30 is in charge of the city's defenses, but we already talked to Asvand. They've been fed up with the sages bossing them around. As long as it doesn't break their employment contracts, they'll turn a blind eye.
That's probably because you've been super great friends with them for a long time. So, how's Sino doing?
The Grand Sage is in his custody. Even I know how terrible it is to fall into Sino's hands, so he probably does too. Sino forced him to release Lesser Lord Kusanali. He has no choice but to obey. So, hurry to the sanctuary of Suristhana. Assuming nothing weird happened, we should have already rescued our Archon. Honestly, I didn't expect our ragtag bunch to do this well. We just came together last minute to save the Archon, you know? Alright.
Yeah, that happens a lot.
I still have to clean up some messes in the city. See you around.
Why? I was already in there. Oh, wait, no, I wasn't.
say, it's nice to meet you. This is the first time we've met in real life. Before, we've only met in dreams, consciousness, or when I was in someone else's body. Thank you so much for coming to rescue me. But I also need to apologize. During this time, I did some self-reflection. My sense of inferiority and yielding to the academia led to all of this, and created so much trouble for you all.
Exactly! We're here because you're a good Archon and one of our friends!
Thanks, you two. Amazing. So this is how it feels to walk out of that cage with my own body. It's like I just had an endlessly long dream. I can't even tell if I just woke up or is only now born into this world. My concept of self has become so clear. But now doesn't seem to be the time to indulge in this feeling. This is really embarrassing. You all just rescued an Archon, and now she needs your help to save her country, and even the entire world.
It's okay. With you here,
another day
I'm
in
sure
the park
that everything will work out.
One more thing.
What is it?
For all the things the academia did to me, and for all the folly it committed in the name of wisdom, as their Archon, I will make them pay.
Ah! Wow! That's the spirit! You're finally standing up for yourself and not letting people walk all over you!
I understand now. To be a better Archon, I first need to better myself. If you haven't even figured out how to be a caterpillar, how can you be a butterfly? Yes, true. That reminds me. I wonder how far along the academia is with their god creation plan. We need to hurry and prevent the birth of that false god. I need to make some preparations. Since I'm now free, I can establish a direct link to the Akasha and control it. First things first. I need to remove the restrictions that the doctor put on me in the Akasha. After that, I'll make some adjustments and revoke the sage's permissions. The Akasha will then be like how it originally was, only operable by the Archon. After all, the academia betrayed Greater Lord Rukadavata's trust. This might take some time. In the meantime, you should also work on your own preparations. If we don't stop the God creation plan in time, we'll be in for a tough fight.
Yes, it's taking me this long to still unlock him.
When we're done, we can take a walk around. After all, we missed out on a lot of stuff when we were locked up.
Oh wait, it has to be. I will clean my... Actually, I did get daily check-ins last week. I did kind of sign in once. That's what I went. As we're ready, let's do some test runs. And this is why I don't use them.
Order guide your
dodge this. Frostbite.
Try not to enjoy this.
Don't blink.
I'm saying Zhongli is great for a shield. Great if you're starting out and you need a shield. Zhongli is great for that. I don't need a shield usually.
Structure and operation procedures are easy for me to understand. Greater Lord Rukidavata's design is truly brilliant. Oh, also, this is for you. Huh? What's this little floaty thingy? It's a small device I put together just now. You can think of it as an upgraded Akasha terminal. You may not need it right now, but it should be helpful in certain situations. Into a situation where combat is our only option, I'll have to count on you, and I'll do my best to provide support. I'm glad I can rely on you.
So the God of Wisdom isn't good at fighting? That actually sounds about right.
I've located where the false god is.
Ow.
Time is of the essence, so let's get to it.
So I guess my stomach is cramping a little. I need want to change. Yeah, I did the daily check-in. That's the new mail.
Let's get down to business.
I figured Elhaven should be a part of this.
Here, the project is a huge undertaking. The sages really saw the god creation plan as their ultimate goal, but this place doesn't look like it could have been constructed by the academia alone. The Fatui under the doctor sure didn't hold back. They provided a lot of technological support.
Yeah, or else they wouldn't have been that generous.
Is that it though? I've always felt that this doctor is different from the academia sages. Doesn't seem to share their sense of urgency. Instead of being interested in the end product, it's like he's enjoying the experimental process.
The Fatui Harbingers are all such weirdos. So, the doctor being weird is actually normal.
So, this Fatui that they're trying to turn into a god is called the Balladeer? We had previously come into contact with his consciousness. He harbors particularly strong obsessions. One is the desire for a gnosis, since he was created to be the vessel for
that. That makes sense.
The other obsession is probably related to his past. I can't quite explain it.
Paimon knows that he was a prototype puppet for the right.
Kyogam before he became a Fatui Harbinger. That's why he wants Enosis so badly. There's no way he'd willingly be a test subject. Now with that temper and ego of his.
It sounds like you know the Balladeer quite well.
I see.
Tell me more about him and what he's like. The more we know now, the better we can plan for and react to any future situation. Get through here and meet him in person.
I thought I saw a chest. It was piping. Cause that goes nowhere. Took a while to change.
We can climb up these pipes.
As long as I just don't fall off every place, because apparently that's what I'm prone to do.
Okay. Let's meet this thing.
I am honestly nervous about facing him.
Hey, Max.
Yes, the plan is not to give this guy a chance to attack. I'm hoping we don't have to do this every time we go to face him. But this is a special.
You'll get frostbite.
Frostbite rebuild.
Incinerate.
plans changed. I didn't foresee.
Really?
This.
Right here. Emerge. Allow me.
There you are.
The cart is stuck. Maybe there's something wrong with the tracks. Let's try adjusting the direction of the device to clear the tracks.
That's what I want. I can't fall off, I can't fall off, I can't fall off. Oh, now we're about the other guy.
Motion to compel. Invisible evidence.
Let's end this quickly. Scatter.
The plan's changed.
Okay, guys, I know this is the last one. I'm just gonna have to pause it for a few minutes.
scribe's work is simple, which is exactly why I took the position. There have been many poorly written applications lately. I guess I'll just have to reject them all. Wait. Huh? No. Whatever. The scribe's work is simple, which is exactly why I took the position. Wait. Huh? No. Whatever. There have been many poorly written applications lately. I guess I'll just have to reject them all. Wait. Huh? No. Whatever. The scribe's work is simple, which is exactly why I took the position. Wait. Huh? No. Whatever. Book learning alone is not enough to cultivate intelligence. All those scholars in the academia are prime examples. Wait. Huh? No. Whatever. The scribe's work is simple, which is exactly why I took the position.
Okay, guys, I'm back. Sorry for that. There we go. Okay, I know. Cancel. I need to finish this, and then that's it. Please tell me I can just jump down. Because I'm not going all the way back through that whole thing. Huh. I wanted to see if there's a treasure chest up there. How? Oh, I really need to stop hiccuping right now.
Status, we must prepare for the worst. The god they wanted to create is likely close to completion or already completed.
Oh no, what should we do? Paimon can't imagine how hard it would be to fight against a Fatui Harbinger with a gnosis.
Are you nervous, Paimon?
If you really want to know, of course Paimon's nervous. Aren't you too, Nahida?
Yes. This is probably the first time I faced with a calamity of this degree since my birth. I feel not just nervous, but curious as well.
Curious? Curious about what?
Curious about our fate. To me, everything we perceive in this world, everything we hear, and everything that happens to us is considered knowledge. And if it's a form of knowledge, then it can be understood. However, only fate is about that which has yet to occur, so it has always drawn my curiosity. So to me, fate is the ultimate knowledge. That's also why I love observing humans and all the things that happen to them. It all brings me great satisfaction. And now, at long last, I'm not just an observer anymore. will personally experience my own fate with you by my side. Isn't this such a wonderfully exciting thing?
This is a completely different fight, by the way. Even though you guys probably already know this if you're watching. Sorry, had to adjust something. But yeah. So. Apparently I didn't even get a choice on that one. I know this is a weird fight. Which is partly why I've been pushing this off. But I need him for materials.
Who would have thought the world would be so eager for my birth? I remember you, Boor, the god of wisdom, and standing beside you, the traveler.
Is Heal knowing and powerful now like Greater Lord Ruka Devata?
No, I can't feel the same kind of divinity I felt from the Greater Lord. It seems that the sages didn't get the chance to infuse the divine knowledge capsules into him. But even still, he has undoubtedly become a true god now.
So we're too late? Baladir has already become a god?
The Baladir. A long bygone title.
Mm-hmm.
When my spirit ascended to divinity, I felt as if I had existed for the same number of epochs as heaven and earth. Looking back, the existence of what once called itself Kuni Kazushi appears infinitely small and ugly.
Aww. That is what I'm naming him. If it lets me, I know what I mean. Yeah. Of course, he has a long ass title.
Feels like a god.
A body that capitalizes on the Baladir's original construction as a mechanical puppet, with the gnosis serving as a constant power supply. How much effort and resources did the sages put into this? From a purely technological perspective, it's a commendable achievement indeed. It's no exaggeration to say, this is the culmination of human wisdom.
You sure are something, dishing out compliments at a time like this?
But I don't think he's reached the spiritual height of a god.
Strife is engraved upon every god and every gnosis brought forth into this world.
Huh.
Can you feel it? The exhilaration of such power. And the thrill of anticipation for our contention.
Nihita wouldn't feel the same things as you!
Do you not realize that you are interrupting a conversation between gods? Lowly creature, know your place!
The strife engraved upon a gnosis. You're talking about the Archon War. Tevat's current peace was not easily won. I didn't personally participate in the Archon War, but the way I see it...
You're playful.
All those losses were meaningless, driven by the demands of the laws. There's no point in bringing it up again.
Is that so? Yet I am deeply disappointed that I was never allowed the fortuity to personally participate in the Archon War. This is a first. Encountering a god in this world who does not crave power. No wonder your own people have abandoned you, god of wisdom. Your judgment is as your existence, unsubstantial.
Oh, okay. I
this
really
is
need
where
to get this over. I'm sorry,
for
guys. I need it, but I need to finish
wisdom.
This. I can't just leave.
You should know that wisdom cannot solve every problem. Like now, where your only option is to face me in combat.
Sure.
Come. Let us reenact a scene of the Archon War. Come and inaugurate my birth as a god. Insignificant past!
swear I switched characters.
Tremble. Burn to oblivion.
Hold the line.
Scatter. Kneel.
I saw that earlier.
Yeah.
you choose to hide behind a mortal.
I highly doubt I'm immortal. You're acting like I'm 500 years old, apparently I slept. Human.
Are you having fun proving a false sense of heroism to yourself, Boor?
Just concluded the 168th loop. Did you know that in the effort to create you, the people of Sumeru were forced to live through the exact same number of Sub-Zero's festivals and Samsara cycles?
The power of dreams. When did you use it on me? Can't even defeat me in a dream. What do you hope to achieve with this little trick?
Come, traveler. Just like before, allow me to awaken the memories in your dreams.
All that battle experience!
It's more than that. Compile everyone's wisdom in the name of the Archon. That is the original function of the Akasha. I've sent everything that happened just now to the people of Sumeru in the form of knowledge. I've asked them to help you find a way to defeat the false god.
Aw, he stayed in Sumeru. At least that didn't look like the desert.
Now,
tricks won't save you.
So, 169th is the charm?
Done with your tricks? Can I finally take this as a real battle between gods?
I'll leave this to you, the first sage of Boor.
Huh.
I am the all-knowing god.
Circle. Ah! Lasers!
Good riddance, cruel world.
Allow me.
Hmm. of lasers.
Humans, filthy humans. That's mine. Don't even try. I'll never go back.
We haven't yet found the answer to the most important mystery. Ermansoul is still waiting to be saved. With the power of another Gnosis, we may now finally understand the last memory of Greater Lord Rukadevata.
Destination, but I didn't expect the remaining consciousness of Greater Lord Rukadevata to be as polluted as this. Forbidden knowledge? It seems you know about a concept that even I don't completely understand. Could you tell me what you know? Your inference seems logical enough. Forbidden knowledge once polluted the desert thousands of years ago, but was successfully repelled thanks to King Deshrit's self-sacrifice and Greater Lord Rukadevata nearly exhausting her power. Then, a second instance of forbidden knowledge pollution occurred during the Khonria Cataclysm 500 years ago.
Okay.
I'm afraid it is much more serious this time, with Ermansoul itself already in danger.
Rukadevata, and it's also been affected by forbidden knowledge pollution, then does that mean, in order to save us, Greater Lord Rukadevata?
Yes. It's very possible that she sacrificed her life in the fight against forbidden knowledge. She didn't completely eradicate forbidden knowledge, but if it weren't for her actions, the pollution would have been far more rampant over these past 500 years. That everyone, including me, has forgotten everything about forbidden knowledge may very well be due to her restoration of Ermansoul.
Do you feel sad, Nikita?
I'm just sharing her pain. The pollution of her consciousness here is severe. There is madness, chaos, and pain all around us. Did she fight to resist the forbidden knowledge pollution in such terrible conditions, all the way up to her last breath. She even used her last remnant of lucid consciousness to leave a clue for us to follow. Yes, her words were distorted by forbidden knowledge, so that's all we could hear. But now, we have a chance to find the answer to this mystery. We can cross the polluted consciousness until we found the right path to meet with her lucid consciousness.
No idea.
And then, we'll let Greater Lord Rukadevata tell us the truth in person. Each of us need to be mindful of the state of our own consciousness while we are here. Even with the Gnosis' protection, we must always keep a clear mind. Otherwise, we could go mad at any moment.
That's so scary.
Don't worry. It should be easy enough for you to keep that mind of yours clear, Paimon. Let's go.
Taking digs on Paimon now. You complimented her. Go around this way, shall we then?
Emerge.
Okay, maybe I was supposed to go that way. Oh well. Small ones, I can do it. Big one. There's more monsters. Ah.
The process of elimination.
What a drag.
No, I miscalculated. I'm sorry, buddy.
Judging from the current route, the boat of consciousness will soon take us out of here.
Who's rowing the boat?
We'll be arriving at our destination soon. How are you feeling? Are your minds still intact?
Huh? But everything's been completely normal for Paimon.
Hopefully there won't be any more interruptions. This time, we should be able to meet Greater Lord Rukidabata.
Are you saying you've never met Greater Lord Rukidabata before?
No. It seems that my birth and her death took place at the same time. Otherwise, I think she would have given me a little more guidance, and I could have done a better job.
Hey, you've done a great job, Nahida! Let's get out of this creepy place and go meet her!
Are you trying to get Bob's attention?
Talking about? The base of Erminsul?
I can't sprint, this is annoying.
Rukidabata?
Yes, that's me. Are you surprised by my appearance? Erminsul and the surrounding lands have been reproduced here as they were years ago. But this is just a realm of consciousness.